The Livermore Water Reclamation Plant provides sewage treatment for Livermore households and commercial establishments and a few areas outside of the city limits. Located on approximately 40 acres, just south of Livermore Municipal Airport, the Livermore Water Reclamation Plant has a capacity to clean over 8.5 million gallons of sewage per day. 90% of that sewage comes from residences, while the remaining 10% comes from local businesses. So how much is 8.5 million gallons of wastewater? That amount would fill 8.5 swimming pools that are each 267 feet long, 50 feet wide, and 10 feet deep. The City of Livermore's first publicly owned treatment works plant, constructed in 1942, was located near Rincon and Pine Streets. As residential areas moved closer to the facility, the reclamation plant was relocated to its current location on Jack London Boulevard in 1959. The plant has undergone four major expansions since then, with the most recent expansion occurring in 1993. Let's explore what happens to wastewater once water goes down the drain. Wastewater, also known as sewage, from homes and various businesses, flows to the treatment plant through 300 miles of underground sanitary sewer pipelines. Most of the pipelines slope downward to allow the wastewater to flow by gravity. In areas where gravity cannot be relied on, the wastewater is pumped up and over hills. The sanitary sewer pipeline system transports millions of gallons of wastewater to the treatment plant each day. The sewer pipes must be cleaned and maintained to reduce the chance of sewer blockages and backups, to remove built-up debris such as roots, grease, grit and sand, and to determine the condition of the pipes for needed repairs and replacement.
So our crews use a closed circuit television camera to basically investigate the pipe. So the camera goes down into the manhole, goes up the line, essentially it's a tractor-powered camera. It's got some little wheels on it and it can go up and down the pipe. And what it does is it gives us a picture of what's going on inside that pipe.
So far, I know this pipe looks dirty. It's been cleaned and it's actually in good condition right now.
We'll be able to see cracks, we'll be able to see holes, settling of the pipe, things like that. Basically, problems that could become bigger problems later, we can kind of catch those now.
The control room is the central location for the plant supervisor control and data acquisition. These computers are set up so plant operators can monitor and control most of the equipment located in the plant. The computers track and log process data so that the operators can see how a process is performing over time. All historical data is backed up and saved on a regular basis. Upon entering the treatment plant, wastewater is elevated by screw pumps to allow for gravitational flow through the treatment plant. From the screw pumps, the wastewater passes through the mechanical bar screen where large objects such as rags, branches, and various floating objects are removed. The bar screen is an automatic device made up of a series of metal bars. As the bars clog with solids, a mechanical rake removes the debris from the bars and places it in a compacting device where the liquid is drained and then hauled to the landfill. Primary treatment separates more than 95% of heavy solids and more than 50% of floating solids from the wastewater. This process starts in the pre-aeration tanks, where air is bubbled into the wastewater to help remove odors and settle out inorganic materials, like sand and gravel, and non-degradable organic materials like eggshells and hard-shelled seeds. The settled material, called grit, is washed and dewatered prior to landfill disposal. Removal of screenings and grit from the wastewater helps to protect mechanical equipment and pumps and prevent clogged pipes in the plant. From the pre-aeration tanks, the wastewater goes into four primary sedimentation tanks where water flows slowly to allow organic suspended matter to settle out or float to the surface. Heavier solids sink to the bottom, where they are pushed by blades to a sludge hopper at the tank bottom. The settled material, called primary sludge, is pumped into the digesters for further processing. Lighter solids like oil and grease float to the top where they are removed by water jets and skimmers. The floatable material, called scum, is collected in a pit that is pumped to the digesters three times a week. The screw pumps and much of the primary treatment portion of the plant are covered to control odor. The odorous air is collected and sent through the odor control tower, sometimes referred to as the Tin Man. Five layers of rock media are in the Tin Man. The odorous air passes up through the media where bacteria growing on the media eat the odorous compounds. The air exiting the tank has less hydrogen sulfide and is less odorous. The Equalization Basin provides a place to divert and hold wastewater as needed to maintain a constant flow through the treatment process. During the day, when there is more flow into the plant, a portion of the flow is diverted to the basin. At night, during low flow conditions, the water that was diverted during the day is pumped back to the beginning of the treatment plant. Livermore's water reclamation plant uses a secondary treatment process called activated sludge. Secondary treatment removes more than 99% of suspended solids from the wastewater. The process consists of two parts, aeration tanks and secondary clarifiers. The secondary treatment process mainly relies on maintaining a happy and healthy bacterial population with a steady food source of organic matter in the wastewater. Aeration tanks contain millions of aerobic microorganisms, commonly referred to as bugs by plant operators. Aerobic organisms can survive and grow in oxygenated environment and are essential to the secondary treatment process. The population of bugs in the aeration tank are called activated sludge. Because the bugs need oxygen, air gets pumped into the water through holes and pipes called diffusers located at the bottom of the aeration tank. Wastewater is then pumped to three secondary clarifiers where scum is skimmed from the water's surface and sludge that settles is scraped from the tank's bottom. To confirm that the amount of bugs in the aeration tanks is balanced for the amount of food available in the wastewater, plant operators take daily samples and run tests. To maintain the right amount of bugs in the aeration tanks, a portion of these solids are returned to the secondary treatment process as returned activated sludge. The bugs that are no longer needed in the aeration tanks are typically wasted after 2 to 3 days as waste activated sludge. Solids collected from the secondary clarifiers are sent to a sludge thickener to remove water. The thickened waste activated sludge, along with the primary sludge, enters the digesters. Digesters are large, heated mechanical stomachs where anaerobic microorganisms break down the sludge solids into stable compounds in the absence of oxygen over an average of a period of 2 to 3 weeks. The water from the digestion process is sent back to the beginning of the plant where it is mixed with incoming wastewater for treatment. The digestion process begins with carbon dioxide and methane gas. Now, the methane gas is used to heat the digesters, but also the buildings right here in the facility. The excess gas is burned off in the water gas flare. Digested sludge, also known as biosolids, still contains a significant amount of water. Belt presses remove approximately 20% of the excess water, reducing the volume of the biosolids. The dewatered biosolids are hauled away to be beneficially reused either as daily cover at a landfill or by land application to non-human consumption crops. To produce recycled water, a portion of the secondary treated wastewater is sent through the tertiary filters, which it travels to the ultraviolet UV disinfection, where the filtered effluent is sent through channels containing banks of UV lights. These lights destroy harmful microorganisms in the water.
This is the UV disinfection building, and we have 2 UV channels. Each one, we can run 3 million gallons per day of water through, and Right here we have a UV module, contains 80 UV bulbs, and those break down the DNA of the microorganisms that happen to pass through for disinfection. This is the last part of the treatment before reclaim.
After the UV disinfection process, an addition of sodium hypochlorite, the recycled water is sampled and analyzed to verify that it has been adequately treated, meets state regulations, and is safe for use for irrigation and fire protection. Recycled water produced at the plant is used to irrigate parks, golf courses, and landscaping, as well as to provide fire protection for airport hangars and some Livermore businesses. The Livermore Water Reclamation Plant supplies an average of 1.8 million gallons per day of recycled water. The treated wastewater that is not recycled is pumped through the Livermore Amador Valley Water Management Agency pipeline to the East Bay Dischargers Authority system. After being combined with treated wastewater from other East Bay agencies, the East Bay Dischargers Authority dechlorinates the treated wastewater and transports it to the San Francisco Bay. We hope that you have enjoyed this tour of the Livermore Water Reclamation Plant. Our role as environmental stewards is important to us. By providing quality, reliable wastewater services, the Water Resources Division staff strives to protect the health, safety, and quality of life for the Livermore community 24 hours a day, 365 days a year.